Now we will see the third proof technique, which is proof by contradiction. Now this contradiction term we used to say many times, that suppose if a person is talking something and later on he is talking something different, then we used to say that how much contradictory conversation he is having. The same funda is applicable over here, that whatever statement you are having, if we are assuming and proving the contradictory statement and if we are getting the same value, then that is the proof by contradiction. So to prove the statement is true, we assume that negation of P is true and negation of P we are taking as premise. So we draw a contradiction F as conclusion from that. So the basic steps for proof by contradiction are: assume that P is false. After assuming P is false, the second step is using this assumption show contradiction. So we will see how. Suppose we are taking example as root 2 is an irrational number. So what is P? That is, root 2 is an irrational number. And what will be negation of P? That root 2 is not irrational number. Now the conditions are that we represent rational number by P divided by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. This is the condition. And the second condition is that where P and Q have no common factor. So these things we have to keep in mind. Now root 2 is equal to P divided by Q. Now take square at both the sides. So root 2 becomes 2. P divided by Q becomes P square divided by Q square. So this we can write as 2q square is equal to p square, means p square is equal to 2q square. Now already this is square and it is multiplied by 2, so p square is an even number. Now put p is equal to 2k. Now we can say that, as we have said, that 2q square is equal to p square, so q square is p square by 2. Now we are considering that p is equal to 2k. So we can say it is 2k square by 2. If I am taking it as 2 square divided by 2, then it becomes k square, right? So q square becomes k square over here. Now put the values. So what we are getting, q square is equal to 2k square, means p is equal to 2k that we have taken. Now p square is equal to 4k square. So that we can write it as 2 into 2k square. Why? Because this k square is nothing but q square. So this 2k square we have written. So this q square is nothing but 2k square. So 2k square means what? It is also the even number. Where if q square is even, means q is also even. And 2 is common. In the 2 is the common number, because q square is equal to 2k square, we are getting 2, and p square is equal to 2q square, we are getting 2. So 2 is the common number in both, which should not be there. That we have seen, p and q should not have any common factor, and that's why this is contradictory. And so negation of p is true, and hence root 2 is an irrational number. So this is about the proof by contradiction. Now the last topic of or last proof is proof of necessity and sufficiency. So when we are, this are particularly about the propositions. So suppose we are having any conditional statement, that is if P then Q. So we can say that P cannot be true unless Q is true, means P only if Q. So for example, we can say that to be true that John is bachelor, it is to be true that John is unmarried. Yes, if I am talking P is John is bachelor and Q is John is unmarried. So if I want to say John is bachelor is true, for that it is necessary, it is true that John is unmarried. So that is the necessary condition, that P is necessary for Q. As John is bachelor, it is necessary for Q to say that John is unmarried. Same way, suppose we are having the next example where being at least 30 years old is necessary for serving in the US Senate. Means the proposition P is you should have 30 years old age, then you can serve in the US Senate. Means P is necessary for Q. If you want to serve in Senate, that is Q, you should have the age 30. Same way, thunder is necessary for lightning. So P is thunder is necessary and Q, we are having lightning. So whenever you are having lightning, thunder is necessary. This is how the necessity conditions are there. Now the next is sufficiency. If P is sufficient for Q, then knowing the value of P true is adequate ground to conclude that Q can be true. Means, if we are having the statements that John is king, that implies that John is a male. So, knowing that it is true that John is a king is sufficient that he is male. Because if I am saying John is king, then that itself gives us the information that he is a male. So, this is the sufficiency way. Then a number being divisible by 2 is sufficient for its being even. Means if we are saying that whatever number we are having, then that if that number is divisible by 2, this information is sufficient to say that the number is even number. So this is the proof of sufficiency and necessity. Now sometimes the condition can be both necessary and sufficient. As for example, today is 15th August, is a necessary and sufficient condition to be the Independence Day in India. So this particular statement comes under the section of necessity and sufficient conditions both, because if I am saying that today is 15th August, then it is necessary that it will be a Independence Day, and it is a sufficient information that it will be a Independence Day. So this was all about the proof techniques that are used in discrete mathematics. So we have seen proof by contradiction and proof by necessity and sufficiency in this section. From our next section, we are going to start our next unit, which contains the binary operations and the algebraic system and the algebraic structure. So we will cover that in our next section. Thank you.